Welcome to Cracking the Horsebeak Code. We welcome you to take the journey with us
as we explore the horse's language, mind, and heart.
Welcome to Cracking the Horsebeak Code. Today, we'll take a look at how horses pay attention to each other's feet and how we can too.
You know, there's an old saying in horse training that you gotta move a horse's feet in order to get to their mind. Well, that's partly true, but when I started to study how horses pay attention to each other's feet, there was so much more going on than just what I had previously thought was going on. And in fact, not only do they listen to each other's feet, pay attention, match steps with each other, they can also use footfalls to say, stop moving. So there's a lot of really cool stuff going on. And to get started today, we have something really special. So what we're gonna be looking at is a brand new baby who doesn't like looking at babies. So this baby was just born and the mama is still going through the birth process. She's gonna remove the afterbirth. And so she's actually uncomfortable and looking to lie down again. So that's what you're about to see, that she needs to tell that brand new baby who just got on his feet.
Not even 2 hours old.
Brand new. He's like, I just learned how to stand. But because she needs to lie down, she needs to tell him to stay put. And she does that in a very special way. So let's see. So here we see the brand new mama and her little baby. And what she's going to be doing in his first hours of life is a lot of communication. But right here, you can see she's getting ready to lie down. And she says to his leg and his foot, she uses her lips. They don't have hands, so they use their lips. She sniffs at front, she sniffs at back, and he leans away. And that's how she says, don't move. That's how she's protecting him when she goes to lie down. You see, he stays put. And later, 2 days later, she now can give him a lot more information about when to move his feet, when to stop moving his feet, by just looking at not only his legs, but also the buttons, which we've talked about on some other episodes, all up and down the whole horse's body. There's these certain areas that horses will look at on each other to indicate what they mean. And so she can use the buttons, but right now she's really focused on his feet. So we're gonna see that her eye is looking right at his hip button. Now as they walk, she crosses over, turns away, and that's the cue for him to stop. And he stops right there in connection with her and turns back around to come over. And this brings us to the horse's compass. So this is just a little adaptation that I drew. And what it represents is that horses have an internalized compass. You know, if you think about their bodies moving kind of like a big boat, then they need the captain's compass. So they have a long head and neck, they have a long tail, they have four legs, they take up a lot of space horizontally. So if you look at this image, we're seeing the nose of the horse and the tail of the horse can go forwards and backwards. And right through the center of the horse, which would be the girth, you can see they could move to the left or to the right. But coming out at the angles between the shoulder and the hip, you've got a possibility of making a different angle, like a 45 degree angle, even a 90 degree angle, a 75 degree angle, actually lots and lots of different angles. That's the little drawing down to the corner. The little drawing in the corner represents the angles of possibility as they pass through each button down the horse's body. So they're very specific.
And this is why it's so important to be paying attention to where your feet are
right. In
relationship to a horse, because they can make so many different choices. And when we ask a horse to move with us, then they are also figuring out in relationship to where we're standing, how they can actually make a step.
Right.
And then there's moments when a horse might not move freely with us if we're close to them on a lead rope, because we might be accidentally cutting them off with the direction of how our feet are. If we're parallel feet and we're standing at their shoulder, the gate is wide open for them to move.
But if you aimed your feet at me,
and if I just turned a little bit
like that, now the direction is actually cutting right in front of me. And that would be the direction of her torso. So horses look at your torso, specifically your belly button area, to see, well, where are you aiming? And they look at your feet to determine, do you really mean
And even
what you
one
mean?
Foot turned in can make a difference too.
It's unfortunate. It's but if I'm amazing. Standing like this, and I've got one leg turned like that, then am I going forward? Or am I going to go to the right? And horses will look at your feet sometimes and go, I'm not sure what you're gonna do. So then they freeze and they're not sure. So a lot of the exercises that we have people practice is paying attention to our feet, doing matching steps with the horse, and giving them an ability to pay attention to our feet too. So that's what we're gonna see next.
Right, and then also just to quickly go back to the image of the compass, is if we're asking the horse to do an inside turn, so if we're in the corner picture and we're standing at the right side of that horse's shoulder, if we accidentally move forward up to maybe the middle of their neck or to their face, then we're actually completely cutting off their
the
ability
movement.
To make that turn.
Right. So it's about learning how we need to take our vertical, long bean pole body, because we have 2 feet and we can just do a pivot. So we can just go from here to there. And they can't do that. They have to really organize this big boat of a body to go around a corner. So part of what we're gonna see next is people and horses paying attention specifically to the human's feet, but also to the horse's front feet in this case. As you progress, you can pay attention to their back feet and then to all 4 feet, and they can figure out if your steps are in alignment with sort of them in general, or just the front feet, or just the back feet. But in the beginning, it's easier because of how we lead horses to really just bring that attention to the front feet.
All right, let's see it.
Horse to human. So here we have an owner, and she is having the horse learn about her feet. So right there, the horse was studying the owner's feet. And here at this moment, she had said, I'm going to move out of the way, but I want you to stay put. So can you go back a little bit for that? Because I'd love for them to see that one more time. So if we can see this, the horse is studying the owner's feet right there. And then when she starts to move, she puts her hand out there. And that's a message, stop right there, that says, I want you to stay put. So this is really important because we don't have a long head and neck, they don't have hands. So that hand gesture takes the place where another horse might use their nose or might use their eye or their side of their cheek.
And they might even do a tail swish.
Or a tail swish, but there's a couple different gestures that a horse would do to say the same thing. I'm looking at your feet, I'm gonna move my feet, you stay there, I'm going here. So that's what they're working out. Now this is a feral horse who had really not had a lot of touch, and so the horse has come in for the last year or so and she's been working with her. And it was very important for this horse to know where the person's bubble was, because she was kind of a bubble popper and she would get too close too soon. So the horse is saying, I want to study your feet and understand where my feet should be. And also, I understand that you said stay put. So that's really important. This is kind of like going all the way back to the mommy and baby picture that we just saw. But now that dynamic, that mommy-baby dynamic, is between a human and a horse. So let's see what happens next. They relax. So this is time out to process, and that's really important. When things go well, it's important to take time out and process. Now here, she's got her whip in position, and she's saying, can you now move along with me? She's pointing where she wants to go, she's got the whip for an activator, but it's not until she lifts her foot that the horse says, I saw your foot move, yes, I can follow you. Because horses look at each other's feet to understand movement patterns because of the compass. So even though she had a whip as a motivator and she was pointing where she wanted to go, it's really the feet that told this horse it's time to go.
Because as soon as the gal lifted her foot, the horse started moving immediately.
And this is just wonderful because they crossed the threshold together in matching steps. So the cool thing about that one little video is it shows how important it is for that horse to know where her person's feet was, especially because in the beginning she didn't know where they were. And this isn't because the person did anything special to make the horse look at her feet. She's been learning some horse speak, and she understood that the horse needs to study her feet.
And
so she set it up
slowly.
That way. And to go slowly.
That was really the big thing, that they needed to work on slow foot movements as well as to practice the bubble of personal space.
Right.
Because as Sharon mentioned, the horse was a bubble popper. Mm-hmm. So therefore that means that the horse is just bumping right into the woman's space.
I don't know where your space is.
Yep. And that's like when we're in an elevator, mm-hmm. especially with COVID, you know, everyone's like, don't look at me or touch me. But regardless, if we graze someone's shoulder, and we're like, oh my goodness, I'm so sorry.
We try to have a couple inches between, even in a packed environment. And horses are aware of that too in nature, but they know how to do it between horses. And because we go right through their bubble, put on a halter, brush them, take them, you know, sit on them. And that's definitely bubble popping. For some horses, they find that confusing. Some horses get it, and some find it really confusing and need a lot of explanation about my space, your space.
And that's why it's so important to pay attention to where your feet are in relationship to the horse. And let's just watch this next video, because
this is funny.
This horse name is Jack, and one of our ladies from England, her name is Linda, and they do a beautiful job practicing together on how to match steps.
And what we call matching steps is when we're moving like that mother and baby in the first scene, just in harmony together. Now he says, what do you want me to do exactly?
And you can see she's touching his front leg a little bit with her finger. And he's like, I don't know about this.
Because to him, that's the wrong leg to start with, which is kind of funny. So she says, all right, well, how about we go backwards then? And he says, all right, well, backwards works for me. I can do backwards. And she's asking at the backup button. And he says, right, I can follow you backwards. No problem.
And he's sniffing her hip as if it were her backup button as well.
He's like, you too.
Yeah.
She says, now, how about forwards? And he says,
so we'll just stop right here.
Okay.
Because of...
I can't wait to say it.
Yes, you're using the wrong foot. And as you can see in how the angle where she lifted her foot and now it's crossed in front of the other one, it is totally causing her to be off balance for one. And then her core is accidentally cutting off his forward movement. So this is the precision that they're looking at with us.
Right.
That if we cross in front of our leg, one leg in front of the other, hey, you're off balance, human. I can't follow that.
I can't follow that off balance movement. So here, just to take, we took a step forward because he was yawning and touching her leg and touching her foot. And he'd been saying, that's the wrong foot. You look like you're going to fall over. And so when she put that foot down and picked up the next one, look at his knee and her knee. Her left leg and his left leg are in matching steps. And he looks very satisfied, and he's happy to put his face forward. Now, she's not doing anything except the lightest little touch on him to say, could you come with me? That's all she's doing. She's not even holding the lead rope. So as soon as she looks like she's in balance, he says, all right.
We're in.
We're dance partners.
Let's do this. All right, we're going to keep going.
And they stop together, and she praises him. Well done.
And he does a little satisfied tail swish, which is so fun. This horse has such a great sense of humor.
Now she picks up that same leg. He says, oh, like, God.
Stop.
Definitely wrong foot. And he goes, he is a picky dance partner. And he grabs his own lead rope and says, I'm taking myself out of here. So she says, oh, come on, you can do it. So he leans away. He says, well, I have to go like this. Fine, I'll do it. He crossed his feet.
Yep, he did.
He said, that's really silly. She said, put your head up, please. And he did. He said, you know, you're really silly. She said, can we do it again? Look at him.
He takes a big breath.
He says, oh, come on now.
He's like, backup woman.
And look at him. I'm taking the lead rope and I'm going home.
He's like, just use the lead rope, Mom.
And he says, all right, fine. Let's just do it. We're never going to get this show on the road, though. And they walk off together. So that is just a humorous way to demonstrate how vital and important it is to them that we are aware of what our feet are doing in the angle. And you can see there that when she steps forward with the outside leg and she's crossing over, he's just saying, that's really off balance. Mm-hmm. And so that's his complaint. He's not mad at her or anything. He's not judging her. He's just saying, you're out of balance. Now, for horses to lose their balance is a big deal.
Absolutely. It is very rare to see a horse fall, cross their legs on
their
own.
Except for babies.
Right, because they're still figuring it out. So that's why it's so neat to be practicing what we're doing with understanding micro gestures with horses through the observation practice of horse speak, because then we can start to see how our horse is moving their feet. And some horses move like Jack, who is he knows where his feet are.
Right.
And then we have other characters who may not know how well their feet move, and they start paddling around, they are out of balance, things of that nature. So then we can actually interject and help them be like, hey, let's pay attention to your feet.
Or we can make it worse by not knowing.
Exactly.
So sometimes if you're standing next to your horse and they sniff down your leg, what we usually find is they're trying to do what Jack did and just say, you're kind of out of position. So a lot of times they might be saying, your toes are cutting off, you're turning in too much, and it feels like you're asking me to go forward, but your toes are actually cutting me off in my compass. And sometimes they're saying, you're stepping forward with the wrong foot, like Jack said. Or sometimes they might be saying, I'd like you to be more towards my shoulder as we get going, because to them, that makes sense. It's called the buddy up position. And you'll see a lot of horses be shoulder on shoulder when they get ready to go, or maybe even girth to girth when they get ready to go, because they have a long body. Now for us, that can be challenging because then we're a bit back. We're a bit far back. You know, you want to be kind of close to the neck and head when you're walking a horse, because you don't want them to get ahead of you and then pull. So a lot of times what I'll suggest there is that we just step aside a little, give them a little space to say, what's the wiggle room here? Not saying that the horse is telling you to leave and you need to move, but just saying you might want to step aside to kind of take in the compass and say, am I crowding the horse by accident? Am I stepping in a funny way? Am I accidentally cutting him off with my toes or my core? So what am I doing that he's complaining by talking to my leg? And honestly, if they're just sniffing up and down your leg or sniffing your boot, that's kind of like the mom in the first one, where they're trying to be gentle, they're trying to make a point, like he sniffs her leg and yawns every time.
Yes.
And then he's trying to be very gentle to the point where he takes his rope and he says, I'm taking myself home.
We're going to walk. I'll get us to walk.
I'll get us there. You're going to fall down, so just lean on me.
And you could see how the moment when Jack liked how Linda lifted her inside leg.
Right.
He also, their knees were in exactly the same pitch, really.
Yeah.
And so then she went back to using the opposite leg, the outside leg, and he's like, no, why are you doing this?
Why do you have two left feet?
And so then it's interesting, though, like that, those are the nuances and the precision that they are paying attention to.
Right.
And then we accidentally, like, may not have noticed. Maybe Linda didn't notice that he lifted his knee a little bit and be like, aha, I figured it out.
And she did later, after she watched this video, she went, oh, now I get it.
It was a really fun meeting talking to her about her video because she was hysterical.
And he's hysterical.
He is.
And a lot of horses are actually kind and trying to just give us a clue about how this could work out better. Because when you see the mama and the baby, she's very kind. She's not going to chase her baby around and make him run circles in order to teach
him
anything.
Even with the amount of discomfort that she was having, right, the vet was on his way to go and help her pass the afterbirth.
Right.
And so even with the discomfort, she's like, okay, baby, you really need to stay put, as I need the space to be able to lay down, because obviously she doesn't want to lay on top of her baby.
So she was being protective. And surprisingly, a lot of horses, you know, so many people have been stepped on. I've been stepped on plenty. And when I realized that they will actually go the distance to try to let you know, hey, your foot's kind, you know, your leg, your foot, your body, your position, you're kind of in a place where you could, if I spooked, you could get stepped on, and I wouldn't want to do that. It makes me think of, we have a lot of cats. We're overall animal lovers. And when it's feeding time, I have 8 cats running around, and they're usually going in and out of my legs. They're weaving in and out, and sometimes I'm like, I'm going to step on a cat. And of course, I don't want to step on one of my cats, but they're so excited because it's feeding time. So the point is, you don't want to trip over your small animals, or if you have toddlers, you know, running around the house. You have to be mindful of the other beings that are moving around you, and they're smaller than you. So I often have noticed that horses can take that attitude with us. But if we don't know to pay attention to our feet, then we don't know to give them the message, hey, I am trying to pay attention to my feet and yours, and therefore give them the opening to start talking about it. And sometimes one of the benefits of paying attention to the matching steps between us and them is that then you're turning ordinary moments into higher education activities.
Absolutely.
So just something as simple as taking the horse out of the stall and out to their paddock to be turned loose in the morning, or from the paddock to the barn to get groomed and dressed for riding, those simple moments are not ordinary moments for them.
As soon as you show up, the lesson starts. And mm-hmm. so you can take those moments and practice precision bending through the gate, for example, or doing a nice little backup right at the gate, mm-hmm. so that there are no ordinary moments with horses, because they are ready to run at the drop of a hat.
And they know where their feet are.
And they do.
Right.
They don't bump into each other. It is
if they can help
rare.
It.
Yeah, I mean,
if they can help it, and if they it's a healthy horse living in a healthy herd.
Right.
So sometimes what you have is a horse who has had neurological problems or behavioral challenges where maybe they didn't get a good elder in their life, and they haven't matured all
the
way.
And when the hat does drop, their reactivity level might be too extreme, and then they may just bump into another horse because they just go blind.
Right, and they just reaction.
Yeah.
And what we've discovered, because we worked at many New England rescues, what we discovered is that the more people paid attention to being accurate with their feet and helping horses to therefore be accurate with their own feet, those horses learned from the people, and when they went back into the pen with the other horses, the other herd mates, they started paying attention to those horses too. So it's a really cool byproduct, because in the end, human beings can have an influence on a horse's sense of well-being. So it really goes both ways.
Absolutely. Because they are trying to watch out for our feet. They really do not want to step on us. But then it is a team effort for us to be able to pay attention to where our feet are and walk in our lane. We have my lane, your lane, the 6-inch rule. You stay over there, I'm going to stay over here.
Like she did with the gesture.
Yeah,
you stay
absolutely.
There. And the last things to keep note of is if a horse stops and their front feet are not balanced, that's saying something. It's saying, like, I'm not completely stopped. I'm still kind of ready to go. They may be still a little bit reactive, or they may have been uncertain about your stopping. Like, did you really stop, or are you just pausing? What are you doing? So we just always tell people, you know, just casually look down at the front feet. Don't get finicky about it, but notice. And if they haven't stopped fully, you might say, I've noticed you're out of balance, and help them get back into balance. Now, if they have an issue, they have pain or strain somewhere in the front leg, that will reveal it as well. So that's, again, another reason to check. Did you stop really well, or are you still kind of out of balance? Because balance to a horse really matters. And what we know is that we try to get maximum impact through horse speak with minimal effort. I mean, that's what this is all about.
Absolutely. And by understanding the micro gestures, it is, and also understanding the perspective of the horse and where their worldview is, and how that they are a prey animal, and that you never know that there could be horse eating squirrels coming out of the trees.
So every day.
In any moment.
Right.
And so the more that we pay attention to what they're paying attention to, and we mirror their footfalls, then we can be in their world instead of expecting them to understand us in our world, in our language.
Right. And that's the bottom line of horse speak, is being able to understand their language instead of, you know, expecting that they just automatically understand ours. So we love to bring little horse speak tidbits to you each time we have one of these shows, and we hope that you found this one to be informative, useful, and kind of funny.
Absolutely.
See you next time.